Hi, I'm going to show you how to use Sklearn to extract keywords from documents using tf-idf. I have this big list of movie plots, and for a given movie, I want to extract its keywords. First, we import from sklearn.featureextraction.txt. We need the count vectorizer and the tf-idf transformer. We'll also use pandas for reading the file. We'll start by using pandas to read the tsv file and store it in a data frame. Now we'll create a count vectorizer object. The first argument is the stop words. These are the words like the and is, which are very common and don't provide a lot of information. These will be excluded from our word counts. Sklearn has a default list of stop words that we're going to use. MaxDF stands for maximum document frequency. Setting it to 0.9 means that if a word appears in 90% or more of the documents, it will be ignored. This will hopefully capture some of the words that the list of stop words misses. MinDF stands for minimum document frequency. Setting it to 2 means that a word needs to occur at least 2 times or else it will be ignored. This should hopefully ignore rare words that aren't useful, especially misspelled words and names that won't help us identify movies. We call the count vectorizer's fit transform function, passing in the list of plots. What this does is actually count the words and store them in a matrix. If we print the word counts, there is one row for each document and one column for each word, which has been replaced with a number, which is the index of the word. What this output means is that this word appears in this document this many times. Let's get the list of words in the documents. We call cv.getFeatureNamesOut and print it. Now that we have the word counts, we can start working on the tf-idf. First, we create a tf-idf transformer object and call fit, passing in the word counts. This is the object that actually calculates the tf-idf for us. That's all we need to do to get the tf-idf. Now, if I want the keywords for a movie, I first get the word counts and then pass them to this transformer. For example, here's the plot for The Avengers and I want its keywords. I used the count vectorizer's transform function to count the words. I put the plot in a list even though there's only one because count vectorizer takes an iterable. Now if I print the word counts, here is a sparse matrix showing how many times each word appears. Now to get the tf-idfs from these word counts, we pass them to the tf-idf transformer's transform function. We'll convert the matrix to a COO matrix, which lets us iterate over it more easily. We'll get the tuples of the matrix. We have the rows, which are the documents, and there's only one in this example. We have the columns, which are the words, and we have the data, which are the counts. If we want the best keywords, then we'll want to sort these in descending order by the data, which is the value at index 2 in each tuple. Now if we print this, we can see that the tf-idf for each document word pair is included. Finally, let's see those keywords. We'll look at the top 20. For each tuple, we'll pass in the column, which is the index of the word, to that feature names list we got earlier. We'll also print the tf-idf. Here are the keywords. Perhaps unsurprisingly, many of the best keywords when we use tf-idf are names, especially uncommon ones. And that's how we use tf-idf to get keywords with Sklearn. If you found this video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.